Innovation hinges on our ability to see things differently. Breaking boundaries and looking between the lines in an effort to solve some of the world's toughest challenges.
Hi, everybody. If you're watching Microsoft Build, you have probably seen one of these innovation videos happening in this stage. Well, I know that you know it, but this stage is not real. I'm actually confined at home, like the rest of the speakers in these innovation sessions. Now, the magic behind this is artificial intelligence. In this video, I want to show you how it works and how you can use it for your own presentations. To do that, let me switch to the real video that I'm recording today. There you go. So you can see that I'm actually at home. Welcome to my house. This is a regular room. I have a couch, I have furniture, I even have some toys from my daughter, which are everywhere. Now, the magic behind this is the setup that I have in front of me. To show you that setup, let me switch to that camera that you see there. Okay, let's go for it. Now, this is the setup. You can see that I have two cameras in here. Now, I have two, but I could use only one if I want to. So this is to switch between the different angles. Now, if you look closer, you can see that these are Azure Kinect cameras. We do that because with Azure Kinect, I can capture also the desk information. And that, as we will see later, it will make my AI model more accurate. I also have a couple of ambient lights. Again, not required, you don't need to use them if you don't want to. And this is my laptop where I have the two Kinects connected. Now in that laptop, I'm running an app called Speaker Recorder that you can download from the GitHub repo. Let me show you that app. Now in this app, you can see that it's capturing the different video inputs. I have the RGB signal from the Azure Kinect cameras. I also have the depth information that we were mentioning before. And optionally, I can also record a PowerPoint video. Now, once I'm happy with the result, I need to apply the AI model on top of these video inputs. To do that, I can also download the command line tool that is available in the same GitHub repo. Now, the output of this command line tool is a video like this. So you can see that it's a transparency mask with my silhouette on it. Now, I can use this transparency mask and apply to my original video, so I can remove the background with anything that I want, for example, the virtual stage. Now, I know that if you are a developer, you want to know all the details. So let me share some of those details to you. This AI model is based on the work from the University of Washington. They recently published a paper where their researchers developed an AI model that is doing that magic. Now, in that AI model is taking two video inputs. The first one, the first image, is the background. So I need to record the background without the person on it for the AI model to work. The second one is the real video, the one with the person speaking on it. Now, the output of that video is the transparency mask that you saw before. But it has some issues. So for example, if I'm wearing something that is the color is similar to the background, I may have like gaps or holes in my body. Not great. So what they did is using a second neural network. In this case, this neural network takes only one video input, and it tries to guess the silhouette of the presenter just by looking at the image, because we know that we have a person in there. Now, that output is great, but it's not as accurate as the previous one. It works great with the background, but for example, for things like the hair or the space between fingers, it's not as smooth. So what they did is combining these two models with a neural net architecture called context switching. What it does is picking the neural network depending on the conditions. So it takes the best of both worlds. Now, in our case, we could go one step further because we have Azure Kinect. So what we did is replacing the second neural network with the silhouette that is guessed by the Azure Kinect, which is much more accurate because it has that depth information that we were mentioning before. Now, we can improve this even further. We can take this model and use another AI technique called adversarial network. What they did is connecting the output to another neural network, which is able to identify if a video is fake or real. Now, if you change the input, if you change the model slightly, the original model slightly, and you try to fool this third neural network, the result will be a neural network, a model that is more accurate and is able to create more natural images. You have all of this process available in the GitHub repo, so we welcome your contributions to make it even better. And of course, it would be great if you use this solution also to record your own presentation, so we can keep enjoying those community events while at the same time keeping the speakers safe. Thank you very much.
Hinges on our ability to see things differently. Breaking boundaries and looking between the lines in an effort to solve some of the world's toughest challenges.